Hey guys, it's me here, Christian, as per usual, and today we're going to review the 1966 The Grinch. This is one of my all-time favorite Christmas specials, and I can't wait to talk about it. It's funny, charming, the animation is great, beautifully animated by Chuck Jones, and easily one of the best messages that even when Christmas is over-commercialized and in many years doesn't feel worth it, it always comes around to... Wait, hold on. What? What? What was that? Okay, I'm getting reports now that, like, I'm not reviewing that Grinch. I'm reviewing a different Grinch.
What am I gonna review, then?
I must stop this hating. For over a year, I've dealt with the marketing now. I must stop this film from happening.
Then he had an idea. An awful idea. Christian Paystrup had a wonderful, awful idea.
Come on, Muse.
We've got a film to review.
So, I saw The Grinch, and to be honest, it pretty much met my expectations, which was somewhere between average and an actual... good movie. Thankfully, it was good, especially when you compare it to the Jim Carrey one. Not that that was hard to do. For the most part, I can honestly say it was overall rather satisfying, which is sad when, aside from the Despicable Me movies, almost every Illumination film is either bland or bad. Or The Lorax, which is the epitome of a guilty pleasure. So the fact that it got to a good enough is kind of satisfying, even though I'd rather have had a pretty good or great in this movie or just from this studio. To be honest, there isn't much to be surprised here. A lot of improvement to the backstory, which, once again, wasn't really hard to do, and especially Cindy Lou, once again, not hard to do, but for the most part, it's the same old, same old. I did think Benedict was proving good, even without his awesome British accent, and considering he has to deal with Boris Karloff's fantastic performance, he did a really good job. Animation is nice, sometimes they're are some actually really beautiful shots, and the Christmas heist in here was flat out awesome. Beautifully homages the original short and is able to bring a large sense of creativity to every house it goes in. This scene is easily worth the price of admission. As for everything else, well, the film has maybe 7 laugh out loud moments, a few nice visual gags, but for the most part, a lot of the humor didn't work for me. I hated the rap music in here. Especially for the Grinch song. And Pharrell Williams as the narrator is just boring and repetitive. Basically everything wrong with narration most of the time. I also feel that a lot of the film was way too padded, which is expected, but the whole getting a reindeer part was just long and rather uninteresting. That being said, as someone who wasn't excited for this, especially after this, I think that I'm just gonna say right now, I thought that The Grinch was a cute, harmless little film. A few laughs, some nice animation, a great performance. To be honest, the message still being as impactful after all these years, I'd recommend you check it out. I'll give it a like reaction.
And you know what? Considering the track record with Dr. Seuss movies, aside from the awesomeness that is Horner's Who, you know, maybe The Grinch is great not because of its story. Maybe perhaps it's great because we can relate to him every year and just have to deal with the cynicism that comes in the real world. And to still find that hope and what makes Christmas special every year is kind of important, I guess. So, it succeeded there.
This is my channel. I can post whatever I want.